When a child attends this program at Space Camp, there is an opportunity for that child's life to change.
It's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for them to meet other students from around the world that are also blind or visually impaired, and to form new friendships and to push themselves outside of their comfort zone.
There we go.
It's addressing the expanded core curriculum, which involves social skills and independent living skills, orientation and mobility, career exploration. So the students are not just learning about math and science and reading. They do mock missions, space missions, where they each get assigned a part and they act out the part and they have a script and they follow the script.
There is no difference between the curriculum for the blind and visually impaired and curriculum for sighted students. Our adaptations for the blind and visually impaired go from simple things like lighting, handheld magnification, we have Braille, we have large print, we have on all the computers here, we have a synthetic speech that the kids can tap into.
And they've done something incredible that even their peers with vision haven't done before. So it's important for them to be pushed and to challenge themselves.
Having a lot of fun doing simulators, talking with friends, learning about new stuff that I never knew about. I've learned how a bunch of jets work and how to have dog fights and stuff.
What they like the most are the simulators. So anything that spins really fast or puts them upside down or makes them feel weightless is what they get most excited about.
My favorite simulator was the MMU, which is basically like a chair and it flips you around in different ways.
All right, are you okay?
Yeah. All right. There is an amusement park type ride called the Space Shot, and that's always a favorite of the students, and it shoots them straight up in the air and then drops them very quickly.
The scariest part of the week was probably the first time I had to go on the Space Shot.
The first day I didn't like it because I almost cried and I thought like I was falling over. I don't want to go to moon quickly like that. I thought I was flying to the moon.
I think it's important for kids that are blind and visually impaired to come here is because just because you're blind and visually impaired doesn't mean that you can't do it.
I certainly agree with that. I mean, and even I believe that if you do have abilities, and not just in science and math, but there are many things where blind people, they're essentially, we can compete with our sighted peers on what is pretty close to a level playing field.
Cody Studebaker, flight director, North Heartland, Vermont.
The parents need to step outside their comfort zone so that their child can. And it's okay for their child to be scared and for their child to be nervous and for somebody to help their child try new things, because that's how we all learn.
I would love to go to space someday. I think it would be pretty awesome.
If you're blind and you have a talent for science and math, a lot of people will say, no, that's crazy, you can't do that. And if you love it, then that's what you have to do. You really, life is too short to get up and go to work every day at a job you don't like.
It kind of changed my mind about who I want to be, but I'm not completely sure. I think I want to be something to do with an astronaut.